Today I want to talk a little bit about Kennedy Brooks and all that's coming up after the bumper.
Don't be cornering me. Hold up. Time. You gotta help me with that corner s***.
What's up, kinfolk? It's RJ Young. I am not on a step mill. Consider hitting the like and subscribe button because I upload a video every single day. It's always college football related, sports related. We have a good time today. I want to talk a little bit about OU running back Kennedy Brooks because I believe that he is approaching some territory that he will not get enough credit for until well after he has left the University of Oklahoma, in large part because he's not what you would recognize as an absolute star in college football, let alone on his own football team. Even this channel, right, has given lots of air to CeeDee Lamb, to Spencer Rattler, to Jalen Hurts, to Baker Mayfield, to Kyler Murray, and on it goes. Kenneth Murray Jr.'s name probably appears in more headlines on this channel than Kennedy Brooks's. Even as Kennedy Brooks is approaching a milestone that only three other running backs in the history of the school have achieved. In 2 years, he has come up with 1,000-yard rushing seasons. And that's not even with him being the primary ball carrier. In his first year where he got the opportunity to do that, it was really by happenstance. It was another injury to Rodney Anderson, who to many folks is like the second coming of Roger Craig with his ability to catch the ball out of the backfield and run between the tackles. And the way that he looked running the football, he inspired so many people with how he was able to just burst and run and fly. And his injuries and his coming back from those injuries adds to his legend. Meanwhile, Kennedy Brooks ascends at a time when we all expected Trey Sermon to ascend. And I need to make another video, do another segment about Trey Sermon and what's going on with him at Ohio State, or what I think is going to happen with him at Ohio State. But with Kennedy Brooks, you're also talking about a running back that has averaged 7.5 yards per carry. That's number one, or tied for number one, with Greg Pruitt in school history. And many people would tell you that Greg Pruitt is the most underrated tailback in the history of Oklahoma football. I would say it's Mike Gattis, but that's just me. The point there is 7.5 yards per carry and over 1,000 yards in two seasons is really, really gargantuan. But this year, in 2020, if he rushes for 1,000 yards, he joins Damon Parker, Adrian Peterson, and Samaje Perine as the only OU tailbacks to be able to do that. And we all know what AD is. He's going to be a Pro Football Hall of Famer, if not already College Football Hall of Famer. Samaje Perine still has the NCAA single-game rushing record with 427 yards on the ground, and I was privileged enough to be in the press box when he did that over Kansas's dead body. And that's the knock on that, is that Kansas was a really bad football team, to which I'm going, you know, there are teams that don't get 427 yards of offense in a game. For him to do that at the tailback position in one game speaks volumes about the kind of player that Samaje was. It also speaks to the kind of player that Damon Parker was, because there are folks, especially from the Tulsa area, that would tell you Damon Parker is the best OU football player nobody talks about, because he was just coming into his own as Bob Stoops took over the head coaching job at Oklahoma, and they were prepared to build the offense around him when he decided to go into the NFL draft early and then things didn't work out. I still contend that if Damon Parker would have stuck around, we probably talk about him in the Heisman Trophy conversation in 99, if not something a little bit grander than that. Maybe he wins the thing. And then along came Adrian Peterson, for which Bob Stoops eschewed the air raid altogether and went back to running I-formation football because Adrian Peterson was that good. Kennedy Brooks won't get that sort of acknowledgement from Lincoln Riley because that's just not the kind of offense that he runs, and that's not the kind of defense he would face. And football has progressed so much over the last 20 years that a guy like Kennedy Brooks shouldn't even exist, because Brooks was a three-star tailback coming out of high school. And while he comes out of Mansfield ISD, Mansfield ISD high school football has not been great of recent, even as they put out outstanding blue chip talent across the board. Like, it's really fascinating from the outside looking in to see how many great players come out of that independent school district, and yet how hard it is for them to win championships. I mean, the entire Mansfield ISD came up to Oklahoma to play Green Country schools, Owosso, Broken Arrow, Jinx, and got their heads handed to them, Union. And yet, Kennedy Brooks can come out of there. And it wasn't as if Kennedy Brooks didn't play great football there. He averaged 7.5 yards per carry in high school. The idea that you would be able to do that in college, let alone at the high major level and then at Oklahoma, should not be possible. And even still, it's possible with Kennedy Brooks looking like he does, because there's nothing about Kennedy Brooks that says he's the next Jonathan Taylor or Chuba Hubbard or J.K. Dobbins, even as he could probably get there. Because it's 7.5 yards per carry. If he got 250 rush attempts, he goes for 1,875 yards. For perspective there, J.K. Dobbins got 301 rushing attempts last year and just went over 2,000, 2,003. And then there's Chuba Hubbard, who got 2,000 yards, mostly on the strength of having outstanding games against Kansas State, against Tulsa, and others, where he was going for 250-plus and puts together the best season of a tailback by anybody not named Barry Sanders. And Barry Sanders, for many people, is the greatest college football player of all time. But with Brooks, the things that make him great are the things you can't teach. He's got tremendous vision. And we layer that one on thick because it's intangible. We can't teach it, right? You either have that instinct or you don't. You know where the play is developing. You know where to go with the football. And he's just fast enough to be elusive, which is to say, if he gets out in front of you, you're probably not going to run him down, even as I bet Kennedy Brooks doesn't break 4.6 in the 40-yard dash. It's kind of like Maurice Clarett in that way. And I think that's the comp for him. If he was given the same opportunities to run the football like Maurice Clarett when Craig Krenzel was quarterback and Jim Tressel was the head coach of the Ohio State Buckeyes, you're probably talking about, you know, one of the greats all time in college, because we all know what it turned out to be for Maurice Clarett when he went into the NFL. Remember, this man famously challenged the NFL's three-year policy, 3 years removed from high school, before you could enter the draft. And I always wonder what would have happened if Adrian Peterson decided to do that, because your earning power is your earning power. And if you can play right away, you can play right away. And while Maurice Clarett clearly could not, Adrian Peterson probably could. Kennedy Brooks, though, is what I'm always going to remember, even heading in this year, as one of the great college tailbacks. And that's a really important distinction to make, because being a great college tailback does not mean you're going to be a great NFL tailback. The idea that you might be Ezekiel Elliott is few and far between, if for no other reason than nobody uses a tailback the way that we would see them used in college. And it's really difficult to be an outstanding tailback in the NFL now, because passing is the future. Passing is the present. You pass first on first and second down, and you have to be able to be a tailback that can catch the ball out of the backfield today, a la Roger Craig way back when. So looking at Kenny Brooks and how he might get used, yeah, I think he goes for over 1,000 yards, but I would be really interested to see if he gets around that 250 carry mark, because there is no Trey Sermon this year. And more than that, Ramondre Stevenson is probably going to sit out the first five games of the season, which means that the guys behind him include T.J. Pledger, who hasn't shown a whole lot, Seth McGowan, who is a true freshman, hasn't played a down, and Marcus Major, who has been basically on the sideline with a busted-up shoulder from the day that he arrived at Oklahoma for the most part. I can't wait to see how Lincoln Riley decides to use Kennedy Brooks in this year where he's draft eligible, because, yeah, I don't think he's going to be a Heisman finalist if for no other reason than Jonathan Taylor wasn't a Heisman finalist. Chuba Hubbard wasn't a Heisman finalist, and J.K. Dobbins wasn't a Heisman finalist. It's a quarterback award, and Chase Young had to be the best player on a football field last year to even get an invite, right? But the idea of a Mark Ingram showing up to win this award just seems kind of far-fetched right now, because Travis Etienne exists, you know, and he's probably going to play on another team that gets to a national title game or a college football playoff semifinal. Brooks would have to carry the football team. And he won't get that opportunity as long as Spencer Rattler is the quarterback, or Tanner Mordecai is the quarterback, and Lincoln Riley is calling plays, because they're going to force the ball down the field. I mean, this is an offense that's averaged better than 44 points per game since Lincoln Riley has been the play caller. So bear that in mind when you're thinking about Brooks, but also do your best to give him his due while he is playing right now, because I think we're seeing him at the height of his powers. And unless something changes, he's probably not going to develop into a first-round draft pick. Or maybe he is one, he just won't get slotted that highly because value is not the same for running backs. But he would have to get into a really great situation to really become an elite rusher in the NFL. And that's the story for most NFL players. You get into a system where you have the best opportunity to win, and the best opportunity to shine, and you can end up as one of the best tailbacks, or you can end up Kevin Falk, which is not a bad thing, by the way. I'm interested, right? Because there's parts of Brooks's game that I feel like we're all going to be in awe of later. But right now, just remember his vision, remember his instincts, and remember it's a once-in-a-generation tailback that looks like Kennedy Brooks and runs like Kennedy Brooks. All right, that's it for me. Deuces.